Hi everybody, my name's Tony and I'm here with the Everyday Counts program. Thank you for joining me. We have an hour together for chair yoga. So we'll spend part of the time in the chair, part of the time on the floor. And for those of you who don't want to get down on the floor, then you can adapt it for a seated practice. Coming to a comfortable place on a chair that is stable and that you make sure you've got a little bit of space around you so you won't be bumping yourself as you move. Rooting down through the feet. Now whether you've got shoes on, socks on, or your bare feet, spread the toes really nice and wide as if you were fanning them out. And then just gently building pressure with the soles of your feet connected down to whatever surface is underneath you. You might even notice as you do that, it starts to wake up some of the muscles in your legs. Keep that connection and that pressure up as much as you need to, just to simply wake up the awareness of the soles of the feet. And then gently allow that pressure to subside. And allow the weight of your legs to sit deeply into that support underneath you. And then from here, we'll do the same thing with our seat. So you can wiggle and waggle a bit if you like. Decide whether you like the support of the back of your chair or you want to sit forward a little bit. And then we sit deeply down into the seat, allowing our upper body to really rest into the chair, waking up our awareness of all the places that our body is supported, backs of the thighs, seat, maybe the back of your body. And then release and soften with that deep connection downwards, allowing that lifting up through the upper body, through the crown of the head, as if your crown of the head was nudging up a little bit closer towards the ceiling. Shoulders roll back and down, and the hands are supported. Take a full breath in, exactly as you are. Exhale, allow a softness to draw into your body and take a few breaths like that. Soften the gaze down, close the eyes if you like, and start to release tension and tightness from your body, making any small or big adjustments that feel best for you in this moment. Keeping the eyes lowered, soft or closed. Take a moment here and notice how you're doing today. If there's a lot of worries or thoughts on your mind, watch them as they come and go, almost like you're watching a stream of traffic going by, as if you were standing on the side of the road. Once you've acknowledged what's present for you in your mind, dipping your awareness down into your chest and heart space or wherever it feels connected to you for how you're feeling, any emotions that are present. And doing the same thing, watching those emotions as they come and go. Without any kind of judgment, without needing to attach a story to anything that arises. And when you're ready, dip your awareness inside your body and start to notice how your body feels today. You might notice sensation or the kind of energy that you have, whether you feel fatigued, whether you feel full of beans, or a little bit in between. And notice if there's tightness and tension in some areas, if you can adjust, adapt how you're seating, how you're sitting to feel more comfortable for you. And then we'll start to pay attention to our breath simply as it comes and goes. Maybe inviting the breath in and out through the nose if that's comfortable for you. Steadying and lengthening the inhale and the exhale so the breath becomes mindful. And you might notice at times, or a lot of the time, your mind draws you away into thinking, or you get drawn away into sensation. When you notice that, just acknowledge what it is that you're thinking about or feeling or sensing, and then coming back to that breath, that steady, mindful breath, which is the foundation of the practice. With that longer, steadier breath in and out, same thing we did with our body. If there's some ease you can invite into the breath, then go ahead. Inhaling and exhaling. Allowing tension to soften, tightness to ease a little. And then we root to rise. Hands dangling down next to you, allowing those shoulders to be heavy and the collarbones to be broad. As you're here, you might notice whether it feels best for you to draw your shoulders back a little or draw your shoulders forward, just playing with the angle of your torso. We tend to lean forward in everyday life, so you could consider drawing the shoulders back even just a little. And of course, it's going to be different for each of us because we're all put together differently. Allowing those arms to be dangling down. With that breath, your own breath length, we'll start to create circles through the shoulders, slow, mindful circles, just like the breath is a little slower and a little more mindful. The inhale draws the shoulders up, the exhale draws them down in a circle, whichever direction you're choosing. Don't worry about what the arms look like. A lot of the time for people, the arms are coming out. Some people, the arms are a little more still. There's no right and wrong here. Notice how your shoulders are feeling. And then we'll take those around in the opposite direction. Today, focusing on those shoulders. At any time, if you need to take a break or do less, please offer yourself what it is that feels best. Allow those shoulders to settle down. And once again, turn inwards, this time taking your awareness to your shoulders, noticing how they feel. Turning those palms out. On the inhale, lifting up the fingertips towards or maybe touching the shoulders. The exhale down. And don't worry about what angle feels best for you. Some people prefer it if their arms are coming more forward. Some people prefer it if their arms are more out to the side or a little bit off in between. Option to stay here. Option to start to allow the hands to rise up a little more, lifting the upper arms. keep it nice and easy. We're not trying to force anything here. If it feels better keeping the upper arms down, please do. The option, of course, is to bring the hands a little further up. You get to decide what feels good for you. Another two, and then next time those fingertips come up towards the shoulders, we're going to keep them there. Collarbones wide, wherever the elbows are, maybe they're down, maybe up towards shoulder height. On the inhale, we're taking the elbows wide. On the exhale, with those broad collarbones, we're taking the elbows in towards each other. Inhaling and exhaling. Those elbows might never come towards each other. It just depends on the length of the bones and the range of motion in the shoulders and all kinds of other places. Inhaling and exhaling your own breath. We've got another two to go. Rest if that feels better for you. End of that next exhale, we'll take the hands all the way down, and any soft movements to release any tension, go ahead. Coming into some shoulder scrubbing. So we're going to turn that left palm forward. Imagine if there's a plate of glass kind of right in front of your hips, and you're spreading the fingertips wide. Slight bend in the elbow. Whichever angle that elbow is bent at, it's going to stay there. So we don't actually move from the elbow. What we're moving from is from the shoulder. I'm going to take my right hand here to show you as if this was a shoulder blade. We're going to start to polish that gloss, plain gloss that the hand is in front of as if it had a rag there. So we're moving from the shoulder joint, inhaling and exhaling. Drawing it in close to the body and then sending it away. But again, the whole movement is coming from the shoulder here. You might even imagine, like I showed earlier, the shoulder blades circling on the back body, keeping the rest of, especially the upper body, as still as possible. Notice which direction you're going in. And then at the end of the exhale, we'll pause, rest for a few breaths if you want. And then we're taking those shoulder scrubs around in the opposite direction. Inhaling and exhaling. And again, imagining that shoulder blade circling around. Make any adjustments that you need to. If it feels better to have the hand more forward or more back, the elbow bent in a different direction. One more if you're not already resting. And then we're going to take that hand down to an imaginary huge mason jar and just open and close that mason jar from the shoulder joint, so not just from the wrist. And taking that left hand back to support. Same thing other side. Keeping that elbow bent at a certain angle, whatever's comfortable for you. It doesn't have to look like it does in anybody else's body. Fingertips spread wide, and as if the palm of the hand is resting against a window pane. And then from there, circling. And this side may feel very different from the other side. There might be more or less movement. It might feel more challenging, easier. Try and stay away from the stories. Just kind of be curious about it. And again, imagine that shoulder blade circling on the back body. You might even notice some snap, crackle, and pops in there. Always make adjustments for yourself. So if it feels challenging, then allow that circle to be a little smaller or bigger, depending on what feels good. You might notice where you're feeling this. It might not be in the shoulder at all. And then at the end of the exhale, we're gonna pause and take that whole thing around in the opposite direction. And you may want to rest in between, noticing how that feels. And again, the movement coming from the shoulder. Another two, resting whenever you feel like it. And then we'll take that hand down to that imaginary mason jar and open and close the top as if you're kind of swiveling it from the shoulder joint. Coming back to center, seated cat and cow here, and then we'll add arms if you want to. Hands resting, rooting to rise. We've got that steady, mindful breath. Beautiful. On the inhale, drawing the hands back as the heart comes forward. Maybe the chin lifts. On the exhale, fingertips slide towards or on the knees. Belly button draws back towards the spine. Back ribs resting towards the back of the chair. Chin coming down. Inhaling and exhaling. As much or as little as feels good here. And when you lift that chin, allow the breath to still flow freely. So there's more of a length in the back of the neck than there is compression. You'll know if it gets, if there's too much compression there, because your throat on that inhale will feel constricted and the breath will not come easily. Inhaling and exhaling, beautiful. If you want to add on with the arms, on the inhale, we're going to take those elbows back, hands in soft fists as the heart comes forward. Elbows come towards each other behind you, and then we're allowing those arms to dive over and down on that exhale. Inhaling, pulling, exhaling, up and overhead. So the inhale, the heart comes forward, and then as we flex the spine, we're using the hands to come more of in a butterfly swimming motion forward. And if there's already a whole lot in the shoulders, we've still got quite a bit to go in the shoulders. If that's too much, then keep the hands down for support. Inhaling and exhaling. Listening to your body, noticing what it is that you need here. Focus on that spinal extension on the inhale, flexion on the exhale. That arm movement can be small, it can be big. You get to choose. If you want to create arm movements at all, we've got three more. Notice what's happening in your spine here. Last one. Bringing the hands all the way back to support. We're going to take those hands dangling next to us, rooting to rise, steadying the breath, allowing those arms to be soft and loose in the joints, collarbones wide and the shoulders are back and down. Crown of the head is reaching upwards. This is the inhale and the exhale. We're going to imagine we're going to pick up something from one side, inhale to center, and then slide to the other side to pick something up. Getting the flexion in the side of the spine. Collarbones are wide here. The tendency is, as we reach, is to come forward. So try and imagine that the shoulders stay over the hips. Even if that means that the movement is smaller, And we really get into the sideline of the body, as opposed to if we come forward, we're kind of getting into the lower back. Mm-hmm. Option, next time those right fingertips come down, we stay broadening across the collarbones. We're drawing that left shoulder back. Excellent place to stay here. You can bring that hand to your hip, reaching with the right hand down and then drawing the chin in. So we're drawing the base of the skull towards the back of the chair, somewhat breathing. Option to stay here. Breathing into the left side of the lungs. Option to take the hand up behind the head, opening up through the elbow, reaching with the right arm, reaching with the crown of the head. So we've got length through the spine, breathing into the left ribs. You get another full breath here. You can always support yourself with that right hand. Stay for the exhale. On the inhale, we're coming up. Left hand dangles down. Reestablish the breath, and we're going side to side. And then the next time, those left fingertips come down. Option to stay. Collarbones wide. That right shoulder drawn back. Chin in towards the chest, and we're drawing the base of the skull back. Right hand can dangle or come to the waist, breathing into the right side of the ribs. Option to stay there, option to take the hand up behind the skull, open up through the elbow and lift. As we reach with the left fingertips or support yourself on the chair, got three breaths here, breathing into the right ribs. Feel them expand and contract. And you've got one last breath, staying for the exhale unless you're resting, and then we'll come all the way up. And again, any movements through the spine, go ahead. From here, taking the hands in front of you. And imagine that there's a wall in front of you, just sliding one arm up, and then we're drawing it down. And we're sliding the other arm up, and drawing it down, palms facing forward. And you can always do this standing against a wall, of course. Reaching, inhaling and exhaling. Don't worry if one side is very different from the other side. Honor where your body is, what feels good. Staying with that steady breath, that inhale, reaching the fingertips, and the exhale, drawing them down just as slow. Option to stay here. Option, next time, one hand comes up, it stays, and then we'll draw the other hand up. And this can be any height that feels comfortable for you. And then from where you are, you're just going to start to walk the shoulder blades up. Reaching as if we're trying to reach up to the tip of the ceiling just and brush our fingertips against it. And again, that can be any height that feels good to you. And we're finding length through one side of the body and the other. Notice where you feel this. It might not be in the shoulders. Finding length through the side of the ribs. You might even feel it in your lower back or your belly. Got two more to go. And then we're going to take those hands all the way down, rolling through the shoulders. Inhaling and exhaling. Coming into a twist, that spinal twist, we're going to take it with the hands down to start with. We've done a lot in the shoulders. And then for those of you who want to add on into the shoulders, we can go ahead and do that. Rooting to rise, finding that mindful breath in and out through the nose. And if you tune in now and realize this is enough for me in the shoulders, please listen to that, please honor that. And you can come back, you can stop this, you can come back to this at any time. There is no need to go through the whole shoulder section if you're already feeling slightly fatigued. That isn't anything you're going to regret tomorrow. Please consider how it is that your body feels. Rooting to rise. This is the inhale, and the inhale is always lengthening through the spine. On the exhale, we're going to start to twist towards the left, just allowing the hands to slide back and forwards up the upper legs. You can look to the left. You can even look back over that left shoulder if that feels good for you. Great place to be right here. Bringing another shoulder movement into it. We're going to take that left hand up, and then we're going to take the right hand and cup it around that elbow. And then from here, this is the inhale lengthening, and on the exhale, we're going to draw the left elbow out towards the left, follow that with the right arm and glance over, inhaling back to center. Maybe looking over towards the left, maybe looking over that left shoulder. And we're getting into the back of that right shoulder as it gets drawn over. Any rest you need to take, please go ahead. Notice where you feel this in that right shoulder. Option to pulse here, option to stay. Three breaths. Drawing over with the right shoulder, guided by the left elbow, drawing you. Keep that mindful breath going. Staying for the last exhale. And then when you're ready, coming back to center, releasing, allowing the hands to dangle, just allowing momentum to draw that forward and back. And then the hands come back to support. Once again, tuning into the breath, rooting to rise, honoring how you're feeling. And then this is the inhale, lengthening. On the exhale, twisting to the right, not going to your full range of motion, just keeping the flow easy, glancing to the right, maybe even back over that shoulder. Option to stay here, especially if your shoulders are starting to feel fatigued. If you're adding on, right elbow comes out in front of you, left hand takes the right elbow. This is the inhale lengthening. On the exhale, the right elbow is drawing over towards the right, and that left arm is coming along for the journey as you twist. Finding a different motion in that left shoulder. You might notice it in the shoulder, you might notice it in the rib cage, the back, the belly, you might notice it through the hip. Please pay attention to what you're experiencing and adapt the movement or rest as you need to. Option to twist and stay. Three breaths. That breath flowing, staying for the exhale, and coming all the way back to center. Dangle those arms, and we're just going to circle through the arms here as if you're kind of, your hands are dangling in warm buckets of water next to you. And then back in the opposite direction. Take a big breath in, exhale it out, tune back in, notice how you're feeling. I'm going to take those feet a little bit wider than they have been. Maybe that means coming back on the chair for more support, or maybe you want to slide more forward. Hands resting, rooting to rise, steadying the breath, always tuning back into how you're feeling, how your body is feeling, what thoughts are in your mind, allowing them all to come and go. And then notice if you need to adjust or adapt something so it feels better for you. From here, we're going to take some hula hoops through those midriffs. So this can be an imagined movement or a small movement. There's not a right or wrong, so it's going to look the same for any two people. So we're all put together differently. We all experience this differently. Imagine those lower ribs hula hooping, allowing the hands to support you as you need to. Not pushing this at all. It's a slow build to allow us to tune into how it is feeling for us. Adjust and adapt it as we need to. Or maybe this gets a little bigger. Maybe the shoulders and the head and the hips get involved. Maybe they don't. Find this movement in your body in your own way. Allow it to be luxurious, slow, mindful. Another three in this direction, resting if you need to. And at the end of the exhale, we'll pause and start to take it around in the opposite direction. Keep it small to start with. This direction will feel awkward. And then we start to allow that movement or imagined movement to get a little more fluid. And that's what we want. We want the fluidity, the flow of the breath to guide the movement. Get as many parts of your body involved as feels good to you. See if you can enjoy this movement. If there's something you can adjust to make it feel better in your body. And we've got another three, resting if you prefer. At the end of the next exhale, or when you're ready, we'll come back to center. Hands in towards each other, interlacing those hands. On the inhale, I'm going to draw the elbows in towards each other, and maybe they come together, maybe they don't, but anywhere near it, no big deal. Wide collarbones. On the exhale, we're sending the palms down towards the earth in between the legs. Inhaling, elbows towards each other, exhaling down. Coming into not only the shoulders, the elbows, the wrists, but also the fingers. Allow the thumbs to get involved as well. With your breath, only pushing the palms down as far as feels comfortable and easy with the breath. And the same with that inhale as the elbows draw in. Not forcing anything, keeping that flow going. And then when you're ready, we'll release those fingertips, a little wiggle, and then we're heel-toeing the legs back into center, washing the knees from side to side a little, and glance away from the knees if you like, taking that spiral up through the spine, and then coming back to center. Take a breath in. Exhale it out, slow and soft. Settle down into the support underneath you. And if this is where you want to stay in the chair, then you can adapt most movements to being seated. And for those of you who want to come down on the floor, I will see you there. there. Bring with you everything you need for relaxation, extra layers, eye pillows, glasses of water, anything, any bolsters, rolled towels, pillows, things like that, and I will see you on the floor. With all your things around you that you need for your relaxation, coming down onto our back, knees to the sky, feet to the floor. Take any extra support you may need underneath your body, a folded blanket underneath your head, anything at all, extra softness. And then from here, closing the eyes or lowering the gaze and settling back into the breath as you allow your body to settle in. Reestablish the breath. And then we're going to take that left arm out around shoulder height, tricep down, and the hand in a soft fist or however it's comfortable for you. So it's around about shoulder height. Right shoulder is rooted, grounded, hand resting wherever it's comfortable to keep that right shoulder grounded. On the inhale, you can do the same thing in the chair. You'll be reaching out around shoulder height in front of you. On the inhale, you'll be reaching towards the ceiling or from the chair in front of you, so much so that that right or the left shoulder, sorry, reaches off the support underneath you. And exhaling it down. Inhaling and exhaling. So there's a little gentle lift. It's a twist through the shoulders and that upper back. If it feels best for you, allow the head to roll to one side. Often that makes people feel a little dizzy, so keeping your gaze focused will help if that's the case. So we're lifting up through that right shoulder. Oh, left shoulder, sorry. We've got one more to go. And then we're taking that left hand down. We're coming to the right side. So the elbow is coming around about shoulder height, resting on the earth. And then on an inhale, we're reaching up so much so that that right shoulder blade comes off the earth or towards the ceiling. So we're lifting up through that shoulder. And allowing the shoulder to get heavy down towards the earth again. This is one of the major benefits of gravity if you're on the floor, is that that shoulder gets to release down to the earth. So we get this opening across the chest. And again, the gaze can come with you if that feels better in your head and neck, or keeping the gaze fixed ahead of you, your choice. And then when that elbow comes down, it's going to stay. And then we'll come into a cactus here. So maybe your hands come to the earth, maybe they don't, no big deal. Elbows towards the earth. If you need to take blankets or rolled or folded towels underneath your shoulders, then go ahead. This is the inhale. On the exhale, we're just rotating through the shoulders, keeping the shoulders rooted, and we're just allowing the arms to come up and down. You might notice that one shoulder, this feels much more comfortable or more challenging in the other shoulder. Exhaling down, fingertips may or may not ever come to the earth, and the backs of the hands may or may not come to the earth, but this is a heart opener and getting that rotation through the shoulders. Such a great functional movement for our day. We need this if we want to stay independent. And then the next time those
hands are up in that cactus. We're going to take some inhaling, drawing the hands towards us, towards the crown of the head, depending on what feels good to you. And then we're going to send the elbows down. And the tendency here is to lift up through the rib cage. But what I want you to do is consider keeping the spine as it is and keeping the motion through the shoulders, not through the spine. So we're inhaling and exhaling. And again, great functional movement here. It's kind of like angel wings, or as you're making snow angels, only hopefully you're not lying in any snow. Great for keeping that functional movement of brushing your hair, combing your hair, washing yourself in the shower, reaching for things overhead. One more. Then we're going to take those hands all the way down. Coming back to the breath, allowing the shoulders to be heavy, allowing everywhere in the back body and your feet to rest. And of course, I forgot to say earlier, your knees can be in towards each other, heels apart, constructive rest in the lower body if you find it challenging to keep the knees hip distance or a comfortable distance for you. With those arms next to you, I'm going to turn the palms towards each other. So the thumbs are reaching towards the ceiling somewhat. This is going to be different for each of us. Palms as far away or as close to the body as feel good to you. Simple movement here. We're going to start on the left side on the inhale. I'm going to bend at the elbow, taking the thumb towards that shoulder, and depending on the range of motion in the elbow and the length of bones, maybe it gets there, maybe it doesn't. Exhaling, the pinky finger is going to make a chopping motion towards the earth, maybe it gets there, maybe it doesn't. Just moving through the elbow. Option to stay here. Option to move from the shoulder. So we're inhaling up towards the ceiling, exhaling that chopping motion down. And again, that arm can come as high up above your head as feels good. Take the entire inhale for that upward motion. Arm as far apart or as close to your body as feels good to you. There's no right and wrong. And maybe the pinky finger and the thumb come to the floor, and maybe they don't get anywhere near it. Don't tell yourself any stories about it. We're just noticing. Our spine is exactly as it was in the two previous movements, just rooted and grounded. We really are moving from the shoulder here. Inhaling and exhaling. Nicely done. Next time that left hand comes down, it's going to stay. You can take the palm down. Right palm is in towards the side of your hip. Inhaling from the elbow up, exhaling down. Maybe that thumb comes towards the shoulder, maybe it doesn't. Same thing can be done in the chair. You've just got gravity a little bit against you in the chair. On the inhale, sweeping the arm up from the shoulder, exhaling slowly down. And again, widen that hand so it's the arm isn't quite so close to your body, if that feels better in your shoulder. Inhaling and exhaling. Keeping it slow and steady. Next time that arm comes down, it can stay. Now you can take five either side or 10 together. Inhaling and exhaling. And this may be very different with both arms towards each other. It takes a little bit more focus on the core muscles to do both shoulders together. Both arms are a whole lot heavier than just one arm. Keep the breath flowing. Get curious about what you're feeling and where you're feeling it in your body. We've got another you're on one side, switch it up, five on the other side, or five together. Flowing through the movement with the breath. One more or less. And then resting the hands on the belly, you're gonna take some steady breaths here, allowing the shoulders to rest deeply. Inhaling and exhaling. Next, we're gonna take those feet a little bit further apart, so mat distance-ish, and that's gonna feel different for each of us. Hands can be down by your hips or in a cactus or a T shoulder height. And we're just washing the knees from side to side. Any SI joint issues, that knee movement is going to be minimal, keeping the back of the pelvis on the floor, supported. Otherwise, option to lift up the opposite hip as you wash the knees to one side. Taking the gaze away from the knees if you want to. And then when the knees come to the left next time, if that feels good to you, allowing them to rest, taking any support they may need. Taking the gaze away over the right shoulder. And the option is here to stay or reach that right arm up overhead. Keeping it there, lifting, reaching towards the top of your mat as the right knee draws down and away, finding that length through the right side and over that right hip flexor. Last option, depending on range of motion, is to take the right hand with the left, or right wrist with the left hand, and draw it over towards the left, and you get a little deeper length through that right side. That may not be for everybody, so come to a place that feels okay for you. If you're reaching or you have that bind in the hands, release that as the arms come down back to cactus or wherever they were comfortable for you. Gaze comes to center as the knees come up and over in the opposite direction. And again, make any adjustments you need to. Knees are over towards the right, left hip maybe lifts if there's no SI joint issues. And the option is to reach with that left arm. So we're really getting length through the left ribs, over the left hip, and then pushing that left knee away in your own way with breath, steady and smooth. Gaze can come away over that left shoulder. Keep the breath even and steady. And then releasing the shoulder, releasing the gaze. The knees come all the way to center. Make any adjustments that you need to. And the knees come in. Give them a little hug. You can rock and roll from side to side a little bit. Knees can be wide, can be towards each other. Getting that compression there. And if this feels good, then stay. If you just want to roll around side to side, up and down the spine maybe. And then option, knees wide towards the armpits, happy baby. And the heels can be down if that just feels good to open up through the groin. Adding on the feet up towards the sky as if that you're in a deep squat here. Hands to the side of the thighs, outer shins, or even those outer feet. And once again, draw the shoulders down towards the earth here, wide through the collarbones. And take some really full, mindful breaths in and out, noticing your thoughts, emotions, noticing your body, how you experience this shape, and if there's anything you can do to adjust it or adapt it for it to feel better for you. You can stay in stillness, you can rock and roll a little bit, anything that feels good. And then when you're ready, the heels come down if they're not there already. And then you've got a few movements or moments here. If you want to add anything to finish up your practice, whatever that may be, get intuitive. Doesn't have to look like anything that you consider to be yoga. It could just be some kind of movement that feels really good in your body. And take those movements for as long as you like. And then when you're ready, no rush, make your way to a place that you would like to finish your yoga practice. On your side, on your belly, on your back, if you have a chair that's a recliner that feels better or a bed close by, please go ahead and do what it is that you need. Otherwise, as you're settling in, adding extra layers, eye pillows, anything at all that feels really good to you. Make sure that you're tuning in to your needs and wants, what your body is asking for, rather than a preconceived idea of what you think the end of a yoga practice has to look like. And as you're ready, starting to settle in and settle down. Allowing your body to rest into that support underneath you, deeply and fully. Allowing your muscles to soften and loosen, your joints to ease. Rest as you are. And taking your awareness down to your feet. Imagine or on an inhale, tense your feet either by screwing your toes in or spreading them out wide, bringing tension into it just for a breath. Exhale, releasing. And allowing your feet to relax. Bringing your awareness into your legs from your ankles, all the way up through your hips and seat. Option to stay here or on one of your next inhales. Draw your legs, flex through your ankles, tense into your legs and hips, drawing the hips in towards each other, clenching your seat for a breath. Exhale, releasing completely and fully. We know that when we relax the body, we get a certain amount of relaxation. When we tense and then relax the body, or even imagine that tense and release, the body relaxes more deeply. Drawing the awareness into the belly. And then imagining, or on an inhale, drawing the belly button in towards the spine and drawing the pelvic floor upwards. On an inhale, hold, and then exhale, release completely. Drawing your awareness up towards your shoulder blades and shoulders. Inhaling gently, drawing the shoulder blades towards each other, opening up through the collarbones, tensing the back body, and exhaling, releasing.
releasing completely and fully. Imagining or taking soft fists into the hands, wherever they are, drawing tension in through the shoulders all the way down to those soft fists, tensing, maybe pushing down into the earth if they're next to you, and then exhale, release. On an inhale, imagining or drawing the shoulders up towards the ears, tensing the neck, drawing the back of the neck back. On the inhale, tense, exhale, release completely. Shoulders heavy, neck and throat relaxed. And when you're ready, drawing your face muscles on an inhale or imagining, drawing them all in towards your nose, screwing them up, getting them really tight. Any other movement that feels really good for you, tensing for a beat. And then exhale, allow the muscles of your face to release completely. Allowing your body to completely soften and let go of tension, tightness, allowing everything to be as loose and as soft as possible. And as you rest in that softness, allow the breath to get softer and smaller. Allow the thoughts to drift in and out of your awareness. Staying there for as long as feels comfortable. And for those of you who wish to stay longer, just let my words and guidance drift over your awareness, leaving you settled and comfortable. For those of you who wish to finish up your practice, become aware of your body as it's resting and the support it has underneath it. Fill your body with your awareness from the crown of your head to the tip of your toes and fingertips, being inside your body, noticing everything that you're aware of inside your body as it's resting. You might notice an aliveness. You might notice the breath, the movement of the breath in your body. You may notice sensation, temperature. Starting to take more mindful breaths in and out. More mindful breath to awaken movements within your body in your own way. Stretching wide, curling in. Maybe you don't want any movement at all and you want to stay exactly as you are. Awakening. taking the next few moments to bring yourself to where you want to finish up. As we settle into support underneath us wherever we are. Hands drawing in to a gesture of closing, whatever that may be. Taking a full breath in when you're ready. Exhale, chin down towards your chest, and take an extra moment to settle and soften the shoulders. Thank yourself for your practice today, and for your time and attention. I thank you for being here. From my heart to yours, namaste.